Okay, here we are. We're about to go make our final push, jumping through the portal and taking on Kucha. I was about to say Kefka. But I just want to point out a couple of little things about this world. Similar to how in Final Fantasy VIII, once you've reached the end game, you are severely restricted on the world map of the different areas you can go. They have done the same thing here, but instead of blocking you with a sort of weird blue portal or whatever barrier that you can't just pass through, what we have here are the roots of the yew tree. Just everywhere. Look at this. Blocking off our access here, blocking off our access to a number of different places. Now, I can still get in Alexandria, I can still get into the Black Mage Village. I guess I could still get in here, but there's nothing here to see. But, I mean, a few areas are blocked off. Now, there are things that I can do. I could not jump through here, I can do a little work on the side to get some better weapons and armor and all that kind of crap. But, you know what? Let's just go ahead with this. Nope. Went right through it. Alright, we are facing a boss battle. All the other airships were capable of showing up, of course, because the mist has returned and it's not only the mist continent, it's all over the place. So they can fly their asses out here and give us a hand. Boss battle, so let's see if it has anything worth stealing. Oh, wow. Okay, I didn't expect that. A remedy, yay. Oh, Steiner's trancing. You know, I don't know if we've really even seen him trance yet. Oh, they're both counter. Oh, the damage there. Oh, Dragon Risk. That sounds awesome. Change the character model. Puts him in kind of a different suit of armor there. It's got a full headgear, headpiece. I guess it doesn't make it quite a shabby. Oh, Steiner's down again. Gotta have one more thing. Take this thing out. Oh, this can be brutal. Oh, what do you know? Apparently that attack doesn't really kill anybody. Seems like sort of like a gravity attack where it just reduces you by a percentage. I mean, you think that would have killed him, but it doesn't. Alright, this is probably the last move that Steiner has before his trance expires. Keep trying to steal. Just kill it. Yeah, well, there we go. BB did it. Love the death animation. Nice to play that at a higher frame rate. Referred to as being Garland, but hey, I can return to the Invincible. at the Zach at me. Can I return to the world map? Yes, I can. Fantastic. If I had to restock up on anything, I could do that. That's nice. Good to know. I don't think it's made clear in this game who you're talking to there, or who Zidane's talking to there. Was it Garland? No, Garland died. Or at least it seems pretty clear that Kuja killed him when he kicked him off the edge. But it's possible that the Garland you're speaking to there is just some sort of construct, just like he's a construct anyway. But a sort of like some sort of remnant of what he was that remained behind. Now, he's still dead, but some measure of his will still remains, and that's what's communicating with Zidane there. Now, you'd always have to ask the question, if it is Garland or some part of him, should you be trusting him? I figure you gotta think about what Garland's motive would be to leading Zidane down the wrong path with me. Of course, Garland's goal was to merge Terra with Gaia, but, well, at this point, Terra is no more, so his primary purpose is now gone. And if his goal is revenge, what can he do with his evil revenge on? Well, it would have to be Kuja, if above all else. So, yeah, I mean, it's kind of a flimsy reason to trust him, but perhaps it's good enough. But anyway, I've gotten past the dragon, I've gotten the Memora, so I'm going to end this episode. So thanks for watching, and goodbye.